going on, everybody? Welcome back to my kitchen. You know, it's so funny because when people come here for the first time, they're always like, man, I feel like I've already been in this kitchen because I've seen it in videos so many times. So anyways, yes, welcome back, as always. Today I have something really, really interesting that I think you're gonna find extremely helpful. We gotta talk about your microwave. It probably stinks. Maybe you've come to terms with it, maybe you haven't. But chances are you've noticed it when you've gone somewhere else, right? Maybe you've gone to someone else's house and you've popped open the microwave or their refrigerator. I don't know about you guys. Maybe I'm like finicky, but I get grossed out. The way that another person's refrigerator smells or the way their house smells or their microwave, and everybody's stuff has a smell. Of course, you become accustomed to your own stuff, but other people are not. So I'm always ultra conscious to try to keep things really clean, whether it's my house, my kitchen, my refrigerator. Microwave, no exception. Now, it was recently Christmas. And on Christmas Eve, I don't do the whole Feast of the Seven Fishes thing, but I do prepare a seafood dish. And over the next several days, I found myself reheating the leftovers. And one morning I came down to make breakfast and I could smell, like there was an odor coming from the microwave. Now, I cannot have that. That to me is just gross, that's foul, and it needs to be addressed. But how do you really clean a microwave? Yeah, you can go in there with some Windex. Microwaves, pain in the ass to clean. And how do you get rid of the odor? Well, I did a little bit of research, I did some digging, and I came across something that I didn't even know existed. Microwave steamers, right? So the concept is there's two lines in there. One line, the first one, you're supposed to fill it to either, white distilled vinegar. Don't go using balsamic, you meatheads, or some lemon juice. And to the second line, you fill with water. Put the cap on, pop it in the microwave, 5 to 7 minutes, steam along with, some of the vinegar or some of the lemon juice. You could also add essential oils to it, will emit from it. And aside from kind of steaming the inside of your microwave, which will loosen up any grime, making it very easy to just kind of wipe it clean, it's also going to serve to sanitize and deodorize it, which is a good thing. So, and this was just absolutely hilarious. In my research, I came across this. Now, full disclosure, let me say, had there been one with a Joe Biden likeness, I would have purchased it just to demonstrate to you my bipartisanship. But this was all that I found. There's also, it was like called like Angry Mama, some like angry lady. But there's an angry POTUS. And you pop his hair off. Same thing. You fill it up, put the hair back on, and as you can see, steam emits from his head. Pretty hilarious. Make microwaves clean again. Come on, that's funny. You know that's funny. So I'm going to show you how this works. It almost kind of doesn't even necessarily require a demonstration. It's so simple, but we're going to do it anyways. And you know something, do you need this item to perform the same task? Maybe not. It's very possible you could just, put some water in a bowl and some vinegar or some lemon juice, some essential oils, and just let it steam. But having used this, it works really, really well. And you know what? For a two pack, this was like $8 or $9 or something on Amazon. So I don't really think there's any good reason to not, but I'm not here to spend your money, of course. So let me show you how we do it. So like I said, you could use vinegar, but I've done it both ways with vinegar and I've also done it with lemon juice. And I definitely prefer the lemon juice because I think it helps to clean just as well, but also has a really nice smell. Whereas the vinegar, your kitchen smelling like vinegar, yes, it dissipates fairly quickly, and vinegar is great for cleaning, but I do prefer the lemon juice. So all you do is cut a lemon in half, and a little difficult to see, but doesn't matter if the seeds get in there. One whole lemon will be enough. And again, if the seeds get in there, it doesn't matter. Just gonna rinse it out when it's all said and done. You're gonna put the rest, water. We're gonna put the lid on. Seven minutes, let it do its thing. Come back to a microwave that's been just totally steamed inside, and we're gonna be able to really just take a paper towel and just wipe everything off. And like I said, it's gonna really kind of get rid of odors, which is awesome. It's the final countdown. 2, 1, disinfected. It's amazing. It's like almost all gone. A couple lemon seeds in there. And it's all like water, like dripping, you know, it's like all steamed up in there. Maybe I should get in the microwave. It may be old, but it won't stink. I kind of just did this a few days ago, so I'm gonna be honest, like it's already clean. But when I did it, I was amazed because like, even like in here, you know, there was like some built up crud and it just boop, wiped right off. So no more smell. Amazing. It literally smells like nothing. It's like magic. And I'm gonna take it a step further. If you wanna take it a step further, sometimes I do this too. Take a little paper plate. Right here, I've got some lime oil. Also rosemary oil. You could use any oil you want. Lemon oil, I don't know, patchouli. I hate the smell of patchouli. All you need is like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 drops. Like overnight. Just toss it in there and leave it. And you'll come down the next morning, the whole kitchen will smell like lemons or limes or godforsaken patchouli, whatever you choose. So, I mean, keep the microwave clean, keep your kitchen smelling fresh. Don't be one of those people, you know, you open up the microwave and I'm like, nah, I'll just eat my food cold. Just take care of that, all right? Hope you found this helpful. Subscribe, comment below. You know, I always appreciate you guys watching. I'll see you again soon.